Welcome to this presentation about the ReqIF's ReqIF Manager. The ReqIF Manager is a tool that is made to exchange data from and to DORA's next generation using the ReqIF format. And one of the most relevant use cases that I will show you today is the support for an OEM to exchange data with multiple partners at the same time. So we first start to create Recif Set, which is the set of modules that are to be exported. We choose the right role, which is in this case customer, and then add multiple suppliers to our Recif Set, in this case supplier 1 and supplier 2. We also would have the ability to put this Recif Set into a folder to organize all those things. Then we are able to define a default view for each exchange partner, which is then being used when adding modules to the configuration. If the view exists, then this view will be used. And also you define default writable attributes, which are attributes that the supplier is supposed to change during the exchange process. And we do this for all the exchange partners. So we don't have to select the view for every module, and we only to define a default view here. And for the writable attributes, we also can use wildcards to define the attributes so that we don't have to put them all in a list if they have, for example, the same prefix. As this is the first export, we need to add modules to the ReqIF set, which is simply done by simply drag and drop a module from DORA's next generation into the ReqIF manager. If this is the first time you need to log in there, then an OAuth consumer session will be created for you so that the ReqIF manager can talk to DORA's next generation. You see here that all the correct view information and the attributes are already chosen for you. And if you would like to add more modules, you simply can drag and drop more modules in there. They can come from multiple components, multiple RM instances. So everything is supported here. If you push on the pencil button, you can edit all the information that is relevant for the exchange. So meaning it's the view and the writable attributes, basically. And you can do this for all the modules and partners individually. As we currently edit those modules new, you also can choose that these new modules are a superset module, which means that these are relevant for all the suppliers, so you don't have to add the modules again for the second and third supplier and so on, so they're already there. The only thing you need to do then is to select the right view so that the supplier gets the right attributes to be exported. So that's basically it to define a small export here. The modules are already checked and you can push simply on the export button and all the modules will be then queued for being exported. If you then go to the export-import jobs page, you see all the currently started or already finished or waiting jobs here. You can see all the details in there, meaning you can see which modules are in which job, for which project and component, which stream, which view, which writable attributes. And if you go with the mouse over the turning circle, you also can see all the details in there, like how far is the progress in DORA's next generation. So we collect task tracker information in the background about all the tasks that are run in DORA's next generation. And when the job is finished, we will collect the ReqIF files and the log files, put them all together here in one place, and do some optimization on the ReqIF files so that these ReqIF files are as compliant and compatible with other ReqIF tools as possible. You see that here with this shield icon afterwards, there is a ReqIF compliance check, which will then check the file if this is compliant with the ReqIF schema. And so it will be able to be imported into other tools than DORA's next generation. If the first job is finished, then automatically the next job will be executed. This will all be done on server side. So you also could basically close your session with the ReqIF manager and come back at a later time and collect all the results. All the created ReqIF packages and log files and everything will be collected automatically in the background by ReqIF manager, and you are then able to download simply a zip package with all the content inside. And you also have the ability then to view detailed log information about the process, how many modules have been exported and how long it took and so on and so on. Yeah, so simply when the job is finished, you can click on the download icon on job level or on module level to download the complete job as the zip package or a single module as a single ReqIF Z package. So let's wait a second for the last one to finish. So we can download all the packages for each supplier. So we now have two download packages for our two suppliers here. And we now have a small look into the log information that is also stored here, which has information on job level, how long the job took, how many modules are in there, and also on a module level, giving you more details about which stream is being exported, which record I have set, and have a link to the door's next module, how many artifacts were in there, when was it started, and so on and so on. So you have all the information about the job here in one place. After the export has been performed, we have a functionality that's called Close Export Session, which will enable you to automatically create baselines on the exported components and to remember the baseline for those modules you consider as being exported successfully. So we have a reference for doing pre- and post-processing for further exports and imports.